Have you ever wondered how you can use your handwriting in your videos? Welcome to this tutorial. I will show you how I'm doing it. I use an iPad and a pencil to get it done. I will go from amateur to pro, starting with the quick and dirty way, progressing into pro, pro plus, and the perfectionist tier level. By the way, my name is Yves, I'm from Germany. Yes, I wear a couple of Birkenstocks, and on this channel I talk about the process of shipping creative work. Requirements. In the first tier, quick and dirty, I use a pencil, an iPad and the app Procreate. You could also use Photoshop, they give you similar results. I just like the brushes in Procreate a little better. In the second tier, Pro, I use Illustrator on top of that to vectorize my handwriting so I can expand it without losing quality. In the third tier, Pro Plus, I use on top of that After Effects to add simple animations to make it look nicer. In the last tier, Perfectionist, I add more complex animations like the hand drawing effect, and also I use sounds to make it more vivid so you can make a masterpiece out of it. Screen mode, I'm opening Procreate, I'm writing something. When I'm done, I'm exporting in PSD, PNG or JPEG. Now I'm importing into my editing software, in my case it's Premiere Pro. I'm putting it into the right folder. Now I'm changing to alpha so I can see it in the preview because it's black on black. I'm putting the text over the layer I wanted to have. I have to place it a little bit and play around with the placements. As you can see, I have different backgrounds. I have a white on black. Here I'm trying to adjust it on black background. I'm playing with the Lumetri color panel to make it white, the text white on black background. Here you see how it looks like. Now I have this example that I would like to add text to. I'm placing it. I also have an arrow I would like to put into it. Now it's time to arrange it a little bit. I use the mode multiply to see it better. This is how it looks like on white background, here on black background, and here in the video. And you can use it for B-roll, transitions, and much more. I'm importing my Procreate file into Illustrator, and if I zoom in, as you see, it's pixelated. It lost quality. It's why I want to vectorize it, because the vector graphic stays sharp if you zoom in, and I want to get that advantage. I'm clicking on Image Trace, and I select in the menu Sketched Art. With that, I see the arrow without the background and can compare it to the original. As you see, I lost a little bit of the arrow. It's why I'm adjusting the threshold. After adjustment, I'm quite happy with the result. I'm clicking expand and I'm zooming in. The vectorized arrow is sharp. The other one is pixelated and it's exactly what I wanted. I have a vectorized arrow. I save it up in AI or EPS and can use it in my videos. It's especially useful for 4K videos. You could ask, wouldn't it be easier to do the handwriting in Illustrator just from the beginning and save the extra step? Yes, it would be easier. I just don't like the brushes in Illustrator. Writing with them feels a bit strange. They're not so smooth. Next, I'm going to show you the text reveal effect that looks like that. For that, we need B-roll, clips with objects in motion, like here. I'm going to select those clips, right click, and I replace them with an After Effects composition. Now After Effects opens and I can show you exactly what I'm doing. I try to hide the text behind the object and then it gets revealed with the motion. I can do that with my iPad, but also with the pencil that has this forward motion. If you're going to film B-roll or buy stock video, try to keep that in mind. Now I'm going to show you how I'm doing it. So I put the clip in position, I right click in the left corner here and I create a new shape layer. Right click new shape layer, then I have it. I will use the pen tool to get it done. So you can select it with the shortcut G or just go in the menu on pen tool. I'm trying to trace the shape, the outline of my iPad, that it looks like that. I have a solid color now. I'm going to change that for a minute so I can see what I'm doing. I'm going to select no color. To get this text reveal effect working, we need a couple of keyframes on position. So I'm going into the shape layer and I'm activating the stopwatch on position. That means a first keyframe is getting generated and I move one keyframe forward. Now I'm adjusting the shape layer's position so that it moves with the motion of the iPad, and I repeat this process keyframe by keyframe till the word iPad in white is uncovered. Next, I'm going back into the color menu and coloring the shape layer back to blue. The color doesn't matter, it just has to be a solid color, and as you see here, it's working perfectly. I'm going to select the layer where I have the text, and I'm going into the drag matte menu and selecting alpha inverted matte. If you don't see this column, right click columns and then on mode. Now you see the effect is working perfectly. I'm doing the exactly same with the pencil in motion and the word pencil. I'm doing it a little bit faster, as you already saw how I did it with the iPad. I'm following exactly the same steps, and here's the end result. The text writing effect. I'm going back into After Effects, and before filming I did it with the PSD file from Procreate. Now I'm going to recreate this effect with the Illustrator file that we did before. I'm changing the color. I use the effect CC toner to change the color to see it better on the black background. There's this icon. If I click it, the vector graphic I'm using, it gets optimized and always stays sharp if I adjust the size. Now I'm placing it and playing a bit around. Now I'm grabbing the pen tool, shortcut G, and I'm within the layer of the arrow, and I follow the outline of the arrow with each click with the pen tool. If I need to pause, I click in the left field, I go back to the layer, and I move on till I'm done. I'm going to animate the arrow. I go to effects, generate stroke. And here I will adjust the settings. At first I click on all masks, then I adjust the brush size to 22. I click on reveal on original image and I put the end to 0, and then I click on the stopwatch icon to generate a keyframe. Then I move forward in the timeline and I click on 100, and that's pretty much it. Here you have an animated arrow that you made yourself. If you have the feeling that the animation goes too slow, you can go in the settings and adjust the keyframe and make it a little bit faster. Now I'm showing you how I did it for this title, quick and dirty. I'm grabbing the pen tool, shortcut G, and I'm following the exact same process, but now I have to be very patient and careful. I'm following the shape of the letter in a way how I would do it if I write naturally. I have to be patient here and careful. I select off and back on for every single letter, and I'm always in the Illustrator file. And for every letter, basically, there is a mask that gets created. If you practice, you can do it in 30 seconds, but at the beginning it took me a lot of time and will take for you as well. Later I will show you a faster process, but this one is like the basic process that everybody should know and learn, because it's a staple. Alright guys, we are so close. Here's the last letter. As you see here, I created a lot of masks. Now I'm going to effects, generate stroke, and I will adjust the settings. They are exactly the same like before. The only difference is the size. It's 33 instead of 22 with the arrow. And now I'm creating an end keyframe. I'm clicking on the stopwatch and I have it at the beginning at 0, and then the second keyframe is at 100, and now the handwriting effect is revealed. If it's too fast for you, you can adjust the keyframe, just move it to the right and you can slow it down so it looks more natural. I like this effect so much, it's so beautiful and it looks like you're writing on top of your video. Here's the second method that I found by coincidence. I'm an illustrator. I copy the arrow and I paste the arrow into the arrow file. And voila, two masks got created. And I don't have to use the pen tool to do it myself. And that's so crazy cool, as you can save a lot of time. I'm doing the same with the title sequence, quick and dirty. I copied it and pasting here into the file. And let's see the results. I'm going into effects, generate stroke, and as you see with the arrow, it's kind of fine. It's not that perfect as I did it before, but it's good enough. But it's not perfect for the title sequence. As you see, the masks are out of order, and it would take a little bit of time to put them into order. So I have to look through them and see what colors get activated and move it around so it's in order. In general, I would recommend that if you have an object like an arrow or something like that, technique two is much faster. But if you have something that needs to be very clean and needs a lot of love to detail, then technique one with the pen tool is maybe the way to go. After Effects is oftentimes considered as the Photoshop of video. You can spice your videos up and give it a unique and personal touch, especially with your handwriting. It's why I love to use After Effects. If you don't have After Effects, no worries, you can do the same in Final Cut Pro or in DaVinci Resolve. Please let me know in the comments if you like this new tutorial style and whether you would like to see more of those kinds of videos on my channel. Now it's your turn to create.